It's 8:24 on this Wednesday morning. You're watching Breakfast Television. Everybody always complains about how hard it is to get out there in the dating world to communicate with people. Vincent King is going to help us overcome that problem this morning. Welcome to the show.
Well, I'm glad to be here.
Hey, yeah. Vincent, it says you're an attraction coach.
Yes.
What does that mean?
Well, for my personal definition of an attraction coach is basically to help men and women to bring out that natural attractiveness in themselves so that other people can see it. Because here's our belief is that everybody's naturally attractive. There's always something attractive about you, me, people in our audience. The thing is, how do we able to communicate that to someone else so we're triggering these attraction mechanisms?
So mainly what we're talking about here is that those awkward first conversations that you have when you're getting to know somebody, where people tend to, we tend to dismiss people very quickly.
We do.
Right?
Yes.
So what is it that you think that we should do instead?
Well, I think the first thing that people should stop doing is to stop interviewing people in terms of they're on their dates.
Well, it's my job.
Well, your job, yeah, of course. You know, which is understandable.
Yeah.
But when people are going on their dates, they are just hammering questions away. It's like, so what do you do? What's your hobbies? And they just don't stop.
And they decide very quickly whether or not they like somebody or
exactly,
not.
Exactly, yeah. And especially for women are very quick. It's like within 30 seconds. And men are even quicker because it's all visual for men. So if you don't look good to them, it's pretty much cut off.
Thank you, by the way, for that. And we really needed to know that. This goes back to the chemistry thing, right?
Yes.
People want to find some kind of magical chemistry between another person.
Oh, yes.
And they give it up right away if they don't see it or feel it.
Yeah, I agree. And they do. A lot of times they don't make the commitment. We're trying to look for that emotional connection right off the bat.
Yeah.
But the truth is, most of the time with people, you know, it takes a certain commitment. You know, like if you see a long lost family member, you may not get along for the first 5-10 minutes, but maybe you spend like half an hour, and you're just laughing your head off.
Right.
And then you forget about the first 5-10 minutes that you've met someone.
So we're too wary, first of all, right?
I think so.
We should commit ourselves into getting to know somebody first.
I think people should commit to getting to know someone, and on top of that, they should talk about themselves as well. So let's say that I'm talking to someone and I ask them a question and they're not very friendly. Well, just answer your own question that you just asked, you know, and so that way they get to know a little bit of you and they feel safer to open up a little bit more.
This sounds like sort of that long lost art of conversation.
People are very scared to reveal themselves now. That's what I've noticed. They're like, I can't be an open book because I'm afraid of being hurt. And it's such a trap they fall in. They never open themselves. And
how much could you possibly let somebody know about on the first date that you would get hurt?
Some people don't know what to tell. So they might tell too much about their past. They talk about the common mistake. My past boyfriend did this. My past girlfriend did that. And it's a dating disaster.
That's a killer right there.
It's
right?
A killer.
Like, date over.
Yeah,
it's
totally, I mean, it's over for me if you're going to have to mention what your boyfriend did or your girlfriend
that's
did in the past.
Pressure.
Yeah.
Okay, so Vincent, let's start from the beginning then. Okay,
of course.
So two people sit down on a date, first date, and try to get to know each other.
Mm-hmm.
What should they do?
Well, the first thing first is that how I like to approach it is that you need to ask emotional questions. So for example, you know, you might want to know about their job, that's great, but really ask yourself, what do you really want to know about this person? What, for example, I always love to ask the question, what was your last great adventure you went on? And so that allows you to open up, is it about traveling? Is it about, maybe it is about work, maybe it's your passion, but that sense of like adventure opens up such a wide spectrum.
Right.
And that's something I'm very genuinely curious about. And so when you're in a conversation, really talk about things that you enjoy and not try to please the other person, because people know when you're trying to please them, and that's when the date goes
it's
bad.
It's a turn off too, right?
It's a turn off, yeah.
So don't try to constantly find common ground. Like genuinely talk about yourself is what you're saying?
Talk about, there's two ways to find common ground, I find, either your common ground is with things that you have in common, like literally things, so snowboarding, skiing. The other thing that we all have in common is our sense of emotions. So for example, let's say that you love to travel. I may have never traveled, but I know what the sense of adventure is. So I might talk about, it's like, you know, I know that adrenaline rush because I went bungee jumping.
So use emotion.
Yeah.
To empathize with the other person.
Empathize with the other person.
Okay.
And we'll always have emotion in common, no matter what.
And what else should we remember?
Always try not to, especially with conversations, try to talk in the I perspective when you're really talking about yourself. So for example, you don't go, it's like, yeah, you know, when you go to a wedding and you do this and you meet the bride and you meet the groom, the person may have never been to a wedding before.
Right.
And so by making the statements, you're making the person feel a little awkward. It's like, okay, I've never been to a wedding, so I don't relate to you. I'm going to shut down.
Right.
And it goes like this. It's blah, blah. blah, 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 blah.
Like the Far Side cartoon.
Exactly, yeah, blah, blah, blah.
So instead relate your own experiences.
Exactly, and always go, I've been to the wedding and I met the groom and I met that. So they start to actually imagine, oh, it's me that's been there.
Right.
Instead of their brain just shutting off and going, okay, I don't relate, too bad.
Okay, but to sum it all up, Vincent, just give people more of a chance than what we're giving them.
I agree, yeah, make that commitment, give them the chance. You know, you never know, because magic doesn't happen right away, but sometimes it happens later on.
See? Isn't that good? That's good advice. Okay, so for more information, check out our website, citytv.com/btvancouver. Here's Dawn.